Sailor Star Maker, Erica Harlacher. And Sailor Star Healer, Sarah Ann Williams. You can start that scene wherever you like. Anywhere is fine.
The stage is yours.
I'm so far away.
She probably sit together just for protection and heat. Warm yourself up.
Eat together.
Yeah.
So you guys want to say hello?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Hello. This is so fun. Hi, everyone.
Wow. There's a lot of people here.
Yeah. Whoa.
We just did an ACON together, and that was a little bit smaller than this crowd, right?
Yes, a little bit smaller. There's a lot of people here.
That's
hello.
Fun.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah, thanks, everyone.
Okay, give it up.
Awesome to be here.
First question. What was it like being in the hottest boy band around?
Amazing.
Yes, that's been one of my bucket list items, so check that off. Hot boy band, cool.
I sing!
Yeah!
It was weird!
It was
cool!
It was so exciting to sing.
Yeah, and
oh my gosh.
It was just really cool to in general, not just be in a boy band, to be a teenage boy.
Yeah.
That was super awesome. And to be famous and wanted by all, that was a really amazing
experience.
But
then
experience.
We also got to be magical girls at the same time.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That was nice.
Yeah.
So happy. That should be all the anime, all magical girl shows from now on should have, like, idol characters.
Yes.
They should all be idol transformers.
They should all let us sing.
Yes. Idol Transformers, that's not what I... That came out differently than I meant. Wait, it's mine. I copyright it.
Wow. Next question. Yeah, so although the Starlights are only in this one season, they're a beloved part of the show. What was it like being part of the Sailor Moon franchise?
So cool to be a part of Sailor Moon.
We got in there right at the end.
Yeah, I know, right?
Stuck in there.
Yay. Yeah, it's just such an amazing universe, and obviously it's, you know, been around for quite a while. But it's the Sailor Moon community is so supportive and awesome, and all the feedback and just love that's been coming my way for playing this character has been really, really cool. So I'm really, I don't know, super excited to be a part of this Sailor Moon family.
Yeah, the first time doing the call out was like really cool. Cause, you know, I know we all have different call outs, but it's the same kind of like cadence. So I was like, Star Gentle Uterus. And I was like, that's cool.
When I saw
you got the good one.
I got the best one. So.
Yeah, in my audition, I was like, should I be saying uterus? I had this hard time wrapping myself around the fact that it was actually uterus.
Yep.
It makes sense now.
Like, it's a big deal for me because I was that little second grader running home after school and watching Sailor Moon on TV. Like, I don't think it's hyperbole when I say, like, not only did that start the whole anime phase of my life, but I don't think I would be here unless I had watched that show and loved it as much as I did. And it's sort of, it's legitimately just now kicking in that this is real. That this happened, and I'm gonna start. Don't cry.
Let's give her some love. Come on.
But yes, it's kind of full circle for me to finally be in this show that was so precious to me all my own, so long.
Makeup. Yeah.
That was good. All right, Lawrence.
So, what challenges did you face with doing both male and female voices for the same character?
I feel spoiled. I mean, I can speak for myself, probably you two as well, that to get to be that dynamic of a character and have a character that is literally, you know, two very distinctly different voices was just so much fun, honestly. To be in a session where you're a guy and then you transform into this awesome, powerful starfighter. I thought it was just fun. There wasn't like an aspect of like, this is challenging. It was just all around, just like, this is so awesome. So,
yeah, it was super fun. Taiki is like, when he's a man, the lowest voice that I think I've done. I did have a bit of a challenge, but it was like a fun challenge. And then when I transformed, I was like, all right, cool, back to myself. But yeah, it was really cool. It was exciting to get to play, like you said, such a dynamic character. And every session was very exciting, and there was never a dull moment.
No, It's sort of a guilty pleasure because it's probably maybe the third time I've played a character that I needed to utilize two voices for. And so, and I really enjoy doing their voice because, yeah, it's a fun challenge to be like, now I'm here, now I'm there.
Yeah.
I love it.
Well, and the boys had such a different, I mean, well, Seiya, for sure, was just like, I mean, so all over the place and like, kind of the cut up and the car, and he's like, you know, shmarmy with Sailor, you know, with Usagi, and like, so there were, it was really cool. If I was a teenage boy, I think that I would have been like Seiya. maybe not.
Taiki's pretty angsty, so I hope.
Yeah, I know.
Like Taiki.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Yakten is my purpley baby.
Yeah.
I love them.
What did you think of their fashions and style overall?
Oh, their suits are incredible, and I kind of want to cosplay in one of the suits at some point eventually.
I fully support that.
Yeah, right?
Thank you.
Big shoulders.
I would look crazy if I cosplayed like that,
because I'm like, I don't know, I'm just very short, so it would look like I was wearing my dad's.
I mean, I would also look crazy.
Well, we would be crazy together.
Like 90s suits, I think you're supposed to look like you're wearing your dad's.
I want a female suit. I've always wanted a nice tailored female suit.
Yeah. Aww.
Yeah,
I mean, because I have to wear it because I am, so, you know, hat.
Yeah.
But it's like, I was wearing one of those nice tailored suits to look all cool in, like, you know, like, what do you call it, Tilda Swinton. She's doing catwalk stuff, and she looks all cool.
So we were talking costumes,
we were.
I was bringing up the episode, God, I don't even know if it's in the first chunk of what's been released, but, you know, say it's in a musical, and he's, like, taking it really, really seriously, and there's this...
You're so bitter, man.
Yeah. I gotta do it right. There's this... outfit that he's wearing in his dance rehearsals that just like slayed me. In the dub, there'd be actually, you know, we don't often play through the entire scene of, you know, what we see and then record. And Susie, our director, was like, you gotta see this. And he's just like flinging around because it's like super awesome short 80s crop top and like awesome leggings, and it was amazing.
Yeah, that's a good
I'm not going to be cosplaying that either, but I would love to see somebody do it.
Yeah, please. You heard her. Please cosplay as the Flashdance.
Yes.
Yeah, please, anybody. I want to see that too.
Musical fan.
All right, next question.
What was your favorite Starlight moment?
Favorite Starlight moment? Ooh. I like stuff at the very end, so I'm not going to get too specific.
That's what I was going to say.
Yeah. We all kind of have some epiphanies and really come together.
It goes from like comedy, a lot comedy. I mean, there's always a serious tone in, you know, throughout the season, but it gets very serious at one point. You're like, oh, this is a total like transition. So yeah, I kind of have to agree though, those end without saying anything.
I also like that one episode where we try and prank the girls, but then
there's
actual monsters, but we're like,
that was a Scooby-Doo episode.
That one's great. I like that one. We're just like oblivious, like, oh, this is wow, good costume.
At the horror film camp. Oh my god, yep. I'm just agreeing with everything you say. I'm like, yeah, that's what I like too.
Yeah.
But those were not the star. Well, I guess they have the first.
Yeah. They transform and then they don't do anything because they're like, oh, they got it.
Like, oh.
Yeah.
Just like we didn't do anything.
We
were there.
Yeah, we're standing up in a tree and we're like, oh, okay, never mind.
They got dressed up for nothing.
Yeah.
There was an aspect, has nothing to do with the actual, on the first recording session that I had, when we, you know, Star, Sirius, Laser, like, I had just come back from vacation, I don't know what was going on with my voice, but I had to do, like, literally 15 takes of that, because, like, every time we got to Laser, it was, like, Laser, like, it just wouldn't come out, and it was just driving me crazy, so that call out that sounds so beautiful, what you just saw was actually a labor
of love. That is my favorite moment, though. Like that first time I got to do the attack call out and the transformation call out, because, you know, again, I'm a nerd. And, you know, sitting there and just being like, I am professional, and inside I'm just being like, anyway.
Oh,
So, do you have a favorite character that you didn't voice in Sailor Moon?
In general, or like just us?
For
yeah.
In
general? Oh god, that's a lot to pick from.
Oh, yeah.
You go first. I really like Cheepy Cheepy.
Yeah.
Aww.
So cute.
Yeah.
She just wants squeezer and
put her in her pocket.
Yeah. So that's fun. I say Cheepy Cheepy.
I like Tuxedo Mask.
Yeah. You hear that, Robbie?
Is this character we wanted to voice, or just character in general we really like?
Oh, if it's someone to voice, oh. I mean, I could steal Robbie's job. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure, why not?
Yeah.
I don't like Sailor Saturn before, because I made up a Sailor Saturn until I realized, oh, there's a legit Sailor Saturn, and I was like, oh, she's so much better than I imagined. She's so cool. Kind of gothy and stuff. It's neat.
Okay, and now we're just gonna ask you to stand back there because we're gonna bring out all of the voice actors and we are gonna start.